Hi, this video is for use to help the student in GT class to export the file properly from Blender. Let's start with the original file. I will open the file from one of our students in the class who allow me to share the workflow to you. He already have the character rigged with the custom bone. You notice that the bone here has 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 spine, necks and the head, upper arm and lower arm, and the fingers. With the hand, just only one bone to represent the central hand and three joints for each finger, which is correctly suitable for the game engine. For the leg as well, just leg, foreleg and ankle. He doesn't use rigify. Which is totally okay if you are okay with working with the forward kinematic, and he has the weapons already mapped to the bone. How do I know that? Because let me just close the bone name a little bit. When you look at the model and you didn't see modifiers, and somehow it kind of stick. Yes, it's kind of stick to the bone, which is this bone. It's called hand R.001. You could assume that you parent this object to the bone. You could check in the object data relationship. You notice that there is a parent and with the bone. To parent it with the bone like this, is this okay? It just kind of one of the algorithm that Unity allow. So that you will have your object attached to the bone. So to export this model, let's check the animation a bit. Make sure that your model doesn't have any action in the action editor go along with, and each of the object should not have the action, including the model and the prop. Only the object that need to have the action is the armatures, and to view the armature action, you need to be in the pose mode. So this is the idle animation, which is totally okay, work in 30 frame. And if you click the shield icon, it means when you press X, all of the bone here are not affected by the animation at all, so you can just reset everything here. But you realize that if you click it, and you click the shield, it will be there is a F icon in front of the animation, which means you kind of save the data block and prevent it from totally delete. It will create a fake users. So let's see the walk animation cycle, which is acceptable for now, and let's try to see the other one, defense. Okay, and attack. So according to the requirement, this model have four animation, which is attack, idles, walk, and defend. And I believe be idle is kind of similar to the original one. So when you export the model, you could just attach one animation to the models, or you could just attach just only what you want to export only. I will try to extract the idles and left the rest of the animation clip here. So let's try to see whether the model can be export and work in Unity properly or not. Let's check the model first. You have the original scale as the identity. As for the object, two of them, right, and the bone. So when you have something like this, you could just save your file and then select the armatures, select hierarchy, and you will notice that anything that has a child of this model is being selected. And you can try to go to export and select the FBX. To export and work in the FBX, we suggest FBX unit scale and apply unit and use space transform. You should not apply the transform. And let's see, we will need the selected object only, and we, I hold shift click and select only the amateur mesh and work and the authors. And let's check the geometry. You should apply the modifiers, and it will try to smooth the normals. For the armatures here, if you click add leaf bone, it will try to add extra bone to the armatures. We don't need this for the Unity, but in the mannequin in Unreal, you might need it. If you click the only deform bone, you will lose some extra bone, such as bone hand dot 001, which you create as an extra. It will export only something that deform, so I suggest you unclick it. If you use Rigify or the author's add-on, you might want to export only deform bone. That's the trick. So for the animation, if you have the animation in action block, as we mentioned, you could click all action to be back. And if you didn't use NLA strip, this is not the nonlinear animation, you could uncheck it. And it will try to have all bone have at least one keyframe, need with some target specification such as Unreal 4. So let's keep it on for now, and I will just export it onto my further works here. Let's just boy model final FBX. When I click the export, you will have to check the console. Let's just see, do we have the console here? Yes. If we enable the console, you see that if the export is finished or not, and you will see that it is finished. Check on the folder, you see that you have one FBX, which representing the model. When you look at it in the 3D viewer, you notice that the sword and the shields are not moving with the animation. This is because you use some kind of the parent-child relationship to the bone. You did not map or use the armature for the weapon and weight pen it to the bone. It will show like this. Let's just try it in Unity first, whether it will work or not. You could just try to drag the FBX model into the folders. I don't mind my mess folder, right? I just kind of want to trace it. Alright, when you import it, you can check on the right-hand side inspector. It seems your model is import properly. Let's check the model here. We use the scale factor 1 and convert 1 meter in the file to 1 meter in the Unity. Actually, we don't have anything specific here. So, if you go to the rig, the generic rig is mean it will retain the original bone structure of your animation models, and the animation is the animation clip that has been imported with your model. You realize that we have the attack animation, the defend animation, and the idle animation, and the walk animation. If you don't want to retarget the animation, you could just keep using it as the generic, which I'm gonna try to use the generic for now. You will see when I drag this model into the scene, you got just original model that worked just fine. Look at the child and the source. You will have original, let's say name of the parent, and then the 3D mesh is the original mesh. It will have minus 90 degree for the mesh. Model import from Blender to Unity, it will have to work with the different rotation axis. There is a way to trick and make sure that it import as 0, 0, 0, but it's not the scope of this topic. I want you to check the sword. It will be the child of the hand.r, which means when you rotate the hand.r, you will notice that the sword just follows. So it just kind of the trick that when you import and export something like this, it will actually work okay inside the unities. And with this example here, you have the root, which is the armature structure, and the shield and the sword are actually part of the the object that being imported. You see, it just being imported, and there is a mesh for the shield and the sword. But all in all, you have some kind of the model to work with, and that's it. If you try to apply the animation on this model, let's see. I have the let's just go to the animators, add the animator to the parents, and I will try to create the animation controllers. Let's see here. Let's see generics humanoid control. So if you assign this generic humanoid control here, where is it? Boy model. Okay, this one. To the controllers. I didn't click root motion for now. When you look at the animator here, you can see you could just try to bring in the maybe the walk, which we're gonna want it to be looped. I will duplicate this clip out, and I will name it generics model that has been walk. Yeah, you realize that this is what I'm trying to do. This is the animation clip that we can work on it, but it just being duplicate from the generics avatars system. I mean, for the rig, it doesn't do anything special, just a keyframe on the bone. If we drag it into here, and let's just say that it will be the default state. When we play the game, you realize that everything works just fine. The animation can be run. The problem is when you use some clip that form the humanoid system. For example, if you use the clip that come from my some of the library I have here, it's just the clip that use the humanoid system. If I just say this, set this as the default layers, and I play, you see that nothing happened. But because when you use the generic, it means that the bone name need to be met exactly the same, which means you could just not use this animation clip, which has a different bone name with another. But if you create another model that has the same bone structure as the generic model that you import the animation clip, it will work. However, if I try to go to the import folders and the boy model here, if I change the mode to the humanoid and apply, and you check that there is nothing wrong with the humanoid head and left hand, right hand, everything works fine. The muscle is working fine, right? And you could just click done. So when you already have the humanoid model, the animation clip that you have here will be as the humanoid animation clip. So in this case, I will try to copy the walk. I will duplicate it. You need to apply first when you do the humanoid. When I duplicate the walk out, right now I will just say that humanoid, whatever is the name of the animation, we have the generic one and the humanoid one. Right now, our model here as the generic model, when we press play, let's see, it will work properly. But if I try to click the model and put it in again, this model use the avatar system, or let's say it use the humanoid system. Let's just name it humanoid. I disable the root motion for now. If you use the controllers for the generic, which means you use an animation of the generic. It's just the animation controller, but the clip inside is the clip from the generic import for the rig. There will be the error that you could not animate it. Somehow it already create the error on the avatar. Let's try to play it nevertheless. You see that the model that doesn't have the avatar work properly, but when you assign the avatar for the humanoid base, everything just gone wrong. So let's try to see if we try to right click and create animation controller again, and this time call it humanoid controllers. So I will assign the humanoid version with the humanoid controller, and in the humanoid controller here, I will use the animation clip from the humanoid import. It's just the same. I mean, this model have the generic from the rig import and doesn't use the avatar system. This model use the humanoid import and use the avatar system. Let's play. Both model work properly, and you see that in the humanoid version, you have some nice trick that you could move the IK of the joint for the hand and the leg. With the script, I mean, it will allow you to hold the gun or aim. So it's just kind of the system that retarget your bone into the common human structures. So if I try to use the generic clip as I do it before, and let's set a default layer state, and I play for this one, you notice that it is broken. Somehow, if I try to, let's say, try to reuse the script from what I do again, just kind of the script that I buy. It could be the script that use the humanoid system. I mean, the model that they create can be different from mine. But when I convert my model into the humanoid and I import the other script, you realize that this model allow us to retarget the animation clip from the author source, which is totally impossible for the generic. If you apply it into the generic one again, if I try to set it as the default for the generic model, it will not do because the model doesn't have the bone name. This is something that you need to be aware whether you want to use the humanoid or the generic version. And if you just import the model as the humanoid and you decide not to use any avatar at all, what will happen? It means it will not working because avatar is just the way that it maps your bone structure to the humanoid system. If I try to disable the avatar here from the humanoid version that I import, and I will use the generic humanoid control to them. I mean, I will try to make two models the same, but this model, actually I change and apply it as the humanoid, and I just kind of remove the avatar out and use the generic control. Will it work or not? It doesn't work because in the generic control, I kind of use the humanoid data, so I will remove it, and there will be the generic model walk. Let's see. It walk properly. So if you want to use the generic, all you need to do is just remove the avatar and use some clip that has the animation for your bone with the same bone name. So this is some kind of the trick that we need to experiment. So in here, you could also create another mesh which has the same bone name and everything. You could even create another mesh here. See, duplicate it as another mesh and just name it 3D mesh virtual. And I will some kind of edit it a little bit. So I will use the G key to make his face a little chubbier and higher. So I will make his bill a little bolder. I mean, if you have structures similar to the original one, and your bone just map the same way as the originals, you could just disable this out for now, and maybe you could just even disable the original mesh and use the second version. I will try to import them all anyways. So I will just select them all and try to go find and export the FBX. I will do the same, and I will just say V2, the FBX. And look at the game engine here, and if I import the V2.FBX, yes, and I just kind of use the generic one. You notice that you have another model that has the same structure of the rig, Panugon model. It's just kind of the name of the rig models. So the model that did use the same rig is this one. So you kind of understand that if you add the animators and you set it to be the generic humanoid control, the model will transition the animation properly. Again, because it has the same bone structures and the same bone name. If you kind of want it to be able to retarget again, you need to set it to be the humanoid. And you could even reuse the humanoid from other model that has been created. For example, I can use the boy original model as the humanoid, and for the V2 here, the chubbier one, I will just reuse from the boy humanoid, so which is this one. You could just say okay. And in this case, for the first boy, it's just generic. Second boy here, I will just apply the same boy model, Phenon Avatar. But you realize that I need to set the humanoid controller as well. For the V2 here, I need to set the humanoid controller as well. And set the avatar to what? To reuse the boy Phenon models. Boy Phenon model Phenon Avatar. I mean reuse the avatar. And if we play it, you see? The humanoid will work properly. So this is one of the issue that you have been asked. If you have many model inside, you see, this is the mesh V2. Where is the mesh V1? Where is it? Because when you export the model from Blender here, you just hide the mesh. You see, hide it out. If you haven't hide it out, it will get export together, and you will have the ability to turn on and off. But right now, you hide it, it will just export whatever it has inside. So if you cut off the hide it like this, and you try to select the hierarchy, with this, you will not select the model that reuse the bone. This is very useful. I mean, you could just create many models from the same structures and just hide it and select, deselect them. But somehow, if you select the hidden model as well, I mean, you just turn everything on, and you just disable the eye. I mean, you select it. You could just try to export it again, and I will just call it V3. And in here, let's see if we have the V3, what will happen? In the V3 here, when you import and bring it into the scene, it will look similar to the V2, but it will have the original information inside. Oh well, something wrong, it doesn't have, right? Let's check on it. Alright. It doesn't have it because it does not active. And let's check our export FBX a little bit. Selected object. All right. So somehow, if we want to hide many model in here, I mean, if we want to get export together, we need to show it. I mean, just show it here. And let's try to select everything again. I mean, sometime unexpected can be happen. Let's just try it before. All right. Just learn it. If there is something wrong, we will see it together. Alright, let's try the V4. So V3, if we hide it and select it, it doesn't get imported. V5, if we didn't hide it, it will come together. Which means we could create the variation prefab that on and of some version out. So if you have different build that come with this model mesh, you could export it together. And it still work well with the animation, which we could try. Try to go to V4 and humanoid and apply. And in this V4 here, just drag it in again. And let's just set the humanoid controller to here. Let's just play it. It will work, right? But if V4 here, I just hide the V2 out and play. It will work as well. So this is useful if you have few model, maybe 2 to 3 model that you want to switch it quickly via the script in the game. It will allow you to just reuse one only the game object. You could use a script to swap the mesh that has been tied to the game object. The drawback is just that when you load the scene, both two mesh will have to be loaded at the initialize of the scene. It will load together. And here come the last part. Many of you of course have the issue with the handheld device, such as the shield and such as the sword. There are some other tutorial that said you should not parent the object to the bone like this. Some say that it will not work in Unreal Engine. So to be safe, I will try to turn off the mesh V2 for now. To do it properly, I mean to do it and allow it to be work properly, you need to find another way. You need to weight paint it to the bone. So let's try it. I will go to the object relationship for the sword, remove everything. Before I remove, it will change the position to the original position, right? You need to, let's say, make sure that the center of origin is the same with the body, or of course the middles. If you didn't have it, you can right click and set origin to origin to 3D cursor, which means you could just shift C, make sure your cursor is at the origin, and right click and set origin to 3D cursors. And then for the bone here, I will try to reset it pose first. Right, so we already have the idle animation, so we'll exit out first. In here, with C, alright. I will reset all the pose. Let's just see the model. We have the origin at the center. All you need to do is just make sure that in the edit mode, it just kind of at the right position, and we have special bone here that could be used as the reference. And the bone name here is the hand 001, and we have the opposite to this side. So for this side as well, I will remove the parent. And its origin is at the good position anyways. If you kind of having the model that you just simply new creating an as a new, make sure its origin is at the origin and the same as the amateur, and then in the edit mode, you just put it into the right position, which could be map or weight paint to the bone. Alright, and here I will try to click the sword. For the vertex group, if you have anything, just delete it all. remove all vertex group, delete all group, and then select weapon, shift left click select the bone, control P, and you could just go to object and set parent and select empty group. With this, it just kind of having the amateur modifiers, but if you didn't have it, just try it again. Control P and with the amateur empty group, your sort should have the amateurs modifier pop up now and the vertex group. So all you need to do is go to the weight pen, and in here search for the models for the bone that you just create. This is the left right, the right side 001. So you select the vertex group and in edit mode, you select everything and just assign weight 1 to this new bone. And you notice that our weapon has 100% bone weight to that special bone that is a reference of the weapon. We'll do the same for this shield as well. So select the shield, shift, left click select the armature object, control P, and with the empty groups. The bone here is the, let's see, the bone here is named handl.001. So I will go to here and search for the handl. Make sure that it is the shield that you selected. And in here, in the weight pen mode or in the edit mode, I will assign weight 1 to handl. When I select everything, select all, assign. And you notice that the handl 001 will have weight 1. So with the with this, we could go back to the objects mode, or in the post mode, you could set the attack, and you see that with the weight pen 1, your model will work properly, and your autoplop will actually have the center of origin at the same as the model. So I will equip this armature with the idle similarly. I will save my file and I will go to yes, I need to select here and select hierarchy. I will not export the V2 here. I will go to export and FBX. This time just call it V5. We have the bone structures the same, but the weight pen for the weapon has been set. If there is nothing wrong, it's finished, right? And then in the Unity, just work with the V5. In the V5, when you drag him onto the screen, you realize that the structure of the original version for the V4 is here. The weapon for the V4 here is a chain to the bone. And for the V5 here, the sword and chain are actually the first in the first layer of the your hierarchy models, and the bone here just control the movement. So this is the generic because I did not set anything, but I can try to find the forearm and hand. Alright, you see that if I rotate the forearm, the shield just follows. And again, if I try to rotate the forearm this side, the weapon just follows. So this is the way they say the best way to do, which is you have your shield and sword already have the weight assigned, and you already have the 3D mesh, which is here, and the shield and sword here has been deformed based on the position of the bone. All in all here, you realize that the location of the shield and the sword are not changed. It's just that the skin mesh has been applied to it. But somehow, to use this model properly with the bonding box, you have to try it. Whether if you attach the bonding box to the sword like this, I will unpack. You could just kind of attach the collider, for example, box collider to the weapon, and then when you play, you will realize that the box collider just follow the weapon position, right? But if you try it with the model V5 when you wet paint it, you need to try. So I will just add the box colliders similarly to the weapon, and I kind of let's see, just delete it first, and let import it as the humanoid so that we can reuse the humanoid together. And in here, the shield and the sword, I will add the box colliders on the sword similarly, and I will just assign the humanoid controller to him. I'll just disable the root motion for now. So we will see whether when we play the animation, will the collider on the weapon work or not. You notice that when you pair the weight 100% to the weapon like this, the collider will not follow because the original model position is at the transform here, and when it change its location of the mesh, it's just because you skin mesh it to the bone. So when you move around, it will not the same as the V4 here, which you already pair it as a child to the hand bone. So there's some kind of the trade-off on here. With the model properly deformed from the original position, it provides the better hierarchy structure that you can turn on and off a specific object very easy. The drawback is just that the box collider will not follow your model. You need a way to calculate it, how you create the hitbox yourself. But for this model, you could just use this hitbox information as the trigger, of course, and use it whether your model just hit the enemy or not. In the end, it just based on your usage, but I hope that this clip will allow you to understand how you export your model properly into the game engine. Thank you so much.